Hey everyone, it is Shannon, and I am here today with a book review, which is something that I haven't done for quite some time. But there are a couple of books that I read while I wasn't making videos that I read them for projects that I do tend to talk about on this channel. So I thought I'd play a little catch up and share with you some thoughts on those books. Some of them are for those books. This one isn't. This is a sci-fi fantasy and weird book, and I will be talking about Guilty Pleasures. But just FYI, these are books that because I read them when I wasn't making videos, I wasn't reading them with the idea of making videos, so my memory is a little hazy. So just, bear with me. I am a creature of habit, so I want to review them, but they might not be great reviews. So I did this happened last year too. I think at the exact same time of year. So yeah, so there'll be some not great reviews. Not that the books aren't good necessarily, but just the reviews aren't going to be great. So anyway, so this is Guilty Pleasures by Laurel K. Hamilton. I read this for my sci-fi fantasy and weird exploration. And that is a project that I started back in 2016 when I recognized that although I love science fiction fantasy and I was curious about what weird fiction was, I wasn't actually reading them very much. So, being the person I am, I made a list and I am working my way through that list. And the goal of the project is to gain more context on these genres that I enjoy and also to hopefully find some books to enjoy. And with this series, or with this project, it definitely is actually to find series I enjoy because so much in the land of science fiction and fantasy is series. There's not as many standalones, that's for sure. And this actually is the beginning of a very long series. This is the first book out of it's this ongoing series, and the 27th title is coming out this year. So that's a long series. This was actually published back in 2004, and it ended up being the 32nd title that I read for my sci-fi fantasy and weird exploration. It then also is on the Vaginal Fantasy Book Club list, and I'm actually working my way through their backlist. I'm trying to read all of the titles that there were live shows for. So there should be a Was this a main pick or an alt pick? If this was a main pick, I will leave a link up above to their live show, which, if there is one, I haven't actually watched it yet. So one more thing to add to my watch later, which is like a little out of hand, a little out of hand. And I also sort of lightly buddy read this with Priscilla. Hi, Priscilla! But we never ended up talking about it. So I would love to hear your thoughts, Priscilla, on this book. We just ended up reading it at the same time. I think we had similar-ish reactions, but I'll get to that in a second. This falls under the genre of sort of urban fantasy, paranormal mystery, but it is, when I looked it up on Wikipedia, they indicated it's a hard-boiled detective novel, which I did not know going in. I read it back in January 2020, and I gave it a 7 out of 10. And also, this series is known for getting quite racy, hence being on the Vaginal Fantasy Book Club list. Yeah, so let's get to my questions. Why did I choose this? I really chose this because it is. I had it. I found it. I found it at a library book sale. There's no more mystery to it than that. So it was available. It was on two of my lists. I decided to read it, and that's really why I chose it. The next question I have for myself is, did I understand it? And I would say yeah at the time, but since then I didn't remember what it was about, so I had to go look it up. So my answer is yes, I understood it, but I didn't retain it. But if you're curious as to what this is about, this is the first in the Anita Blake Vampire Hunter series, and we follow Anita Blake, who is, I don't, she's doesn't really seem to be a vampire hunter in this one. She is a necromancer, and I think she's a detective or a PI, something of that ilk. And then she is hired by a vampire because there are some killings going on that look like it's another vampire, and one vampire is like, I want to know the vampire who's doing this. Everyone is petrified of vampires in general, and the particular person who hires her, and there's quite a hierarchy, and there's lots of fear in terms of all of the levels of that. There's so much tension in this one in terms of that I found it actually quite uncomfortable. Anyway, this sort of serves as an introduction to the world, of course, because it's the first in a long-going series, and it really, one of the things that I did enjoy about this one is that she really is a tough cookie. She is not going to back down, and so many other people do. So that's one of the strong tension. There's lots of tension in this one because of that. You know, people are afraid of the vampires, and there's also other paranormal beings, and I don't know if they're out in the world. I think the vampires are out, but not everyone is. And I did like some of the other people she came in contact with. She was, you know, curious, and like she was willing to like work with anyone who was willing to work with her. And but often people were only willing to go so far because the vampires are very strong and powerful and threatening, intimidating, and all of those things. So yeah. And then so another question I have for myself is, did I enjoy it? And I gotta say, not so much. This really wasn't what I was expecting. I was expecting it to be really racy and stuff like that, and there wasn't any of that really going on in this one. Apparently it's more in the later novels. This one just sort of has hints at potential relationships or encounters, who knows. I think there might be both as the series goes on. Yeah, I just the amount of tension in this one, it didn't work for me. And it felt more brutal. It's much more dark. The fact that it's hard-boiled detective is much more in line of the tone of it. Like, it reminds me a little bit more of the In Death series by J.D. Robb, who's Nora Roberts, and which was a series that I wasn't that interested in. And there's just, it's just too gruesome for me. And also there was definitely some indication that a lot of people didn't feel at choice with things. In this one, there was a party scene, you know, and there were some people that certainly didn't feel like they were at choice in this party situation. And so that I was really uncomfortable with as well. And she was trying to help them out, but it was a bit of a sticky situation and all that stuff. But it just didn't work for me. Like, it just was not tonally what I was looking for, even though, you know, I do like a lot of paranormal and urban fantasy. But just tonally, it was too dark, too brutal. And it wasn't even that dark or that brutal. It just wasn't a good fit. So I don't know. One of my other questions is, was it what I expected? And I would say, no, not at all. I really thought this would be more fun or racy or, and so it just really wasn't. And I don't know if part of that is because it's the beginning of a series and because it was published now 16 years ago. I've read a lot of stories and series like this that were started later. So I think maybe they're less dark, or I have seen sort of like this type of character, these type of situations again and again and again. So I don't know. So there is lots to choose from, that's for sure. But for me, I don't think I'll be continuing the series because I think the next one's called like The Corpse something. And I'm just like, yeah, no, the sort of darker stuff. I like long arc urban fantasies that are more epic or character driven as opposed to murder, mystery, mayhem related. And there are so many of them that you really do have, you know, a lot to choose from. So, but I tend to like ones that are more character-y. So yeah. And so let me know, have you read this? Did you enjoy it? What was it about it that you enjoyed? And if you didn't like it, what other series of this sort of genre of urban fantasy do you like? I know for me, I'm a big fan of the Kate Daniels series, and I've also enjoyed the Mercy Thompson series, but I think for me, Kate Daniels is my favorite, and that completed at 10 books, which I also really appreciate, because I find a lot of urban fantasy and paranormal romance, especially when it has a sort of mystery per book, it just seems to go on indefinitely. So yeah, if you have any long arc urban fantasy recommendations, I'd love to hear them. And yeah, so those are my thoughts on Guilty Pleasures. I will be back next with a book that fits both my science fiction fantasy and my those books exploration, and that's going to be Dune. So that'll be interesting. That'll be interesting to talk about. That's a long one, and it took me a long time to read, but I did it. So yeah, let me know your thoughts on Guilty Pleasures, and I'll be back with another video very soon.